You shouldn't drink because it leads to bad things. I was in jail for the night, and well, I guess, I don't know. I just don't drink. But if you must drink, definitely don't drive. I've definitely learned that firsthand. That's all, I guess. Well, I think we've all learned an important lesson, haven't we, class? If you don't make the right choices in life, you could end up being a big loser like Stan's dad. Drinking and driving is for idiots. Nobody wants to end up like Stan's dad, do they? I want you all to take a good look at Stan's dad and say, "Is that who I want to be in 30 years?" Getting tickets and having to go to elementary school classrooms and talk about how pathetic I am. Thank you, Mr. Marsh. I think you made your point.
Hi everyone, we're going to be talking about a rather bizarre subject, reptilians. Now bear with me because my consensus on these things is that I don't entirely believe that they exist, although I do feel that it's a possibility, only because, I mean, look at us. We are a grain of sand on the beach, okay? We are a teeny tiny little planet, and we got this entire macrocosm of a universe just all around us. Millions, billions, trillions, quadzillions, whatever you want to think of is there, and it's gigantic. And for someone to claim that there is no life and we are the only ones here, I don't think so. I'm sorry, but that is just ridiculous. I don't think so. Now, to begin, I cannot deny the historical, testimonial, and cultural evidence of these reptilian serpent god beings. Because somewhere along the lines, repeating in history, is these dragon things. But I am going to try to prove their existence, and I'm going to try to disprove their existence. So, okay. And I'm also going to relay my experience briefly. But I feel that it was a sleep paralysis experience does not count as it being real. Meaning, I don't think that I really saw these things. I think it was more of a hallucination type of thing going on in my mind. Who knows what I could have seen when I was a child? Who knows what I could have, what kind of movie I could have seen 3 days ago, and I don't remember, and it could have just jumbled up in there, and sometimes things happen. It triggers something in your brain. Now, here we go. 3 or 4 years ago, I was at my grandmother's apartment, and upon going to bed, I had this dream. It was extremely lucid, and I felt that I was really there because it was so clear. And what it was a laboratory hospital kind of building. And there was a hallway going down. It looked like just an old doctor's office with all these doors and everything. And I came across this entire section of scientific instruments and jars. And I was like, when I was down there, I was thinking, I wasn't thinking this is weird or this is bizarre. I was just thinking, oh, okay, cool, whatever, But I did get scared later on, and that fear made me, paralyzed. But I'll explain that in a minute. So I looked closer at the jars, and I saw that there are human fetuses in it or something, and it was really strange. And then I looked to my left or my right or something, and there's this tiny, I don't know, about like 4 feet tall, this little gremlin-looking thing. And the description of it is pretty much like a reptilian, except that it had a weird-looking face. It was a compressed nose. It had a large grin, like a Cheshire cat. Excuse me. And it was just really strange. It had these large eyes with cat-like pupils, and its skin tone was dark green. On the underside, it was much lighter, and it was making these weird breathing sounds. And as I'm looking around, it's all like, jagged movements. And another one came up from behind it. And when I was looking at this, I was thinking, weird. Not weird, but just this is interesting, but I think it's time to go. So I got kind of afraid, and at that moment of being afraid, all of a sudden I found myself in my bedroom, back in the same place, and I was completely frozen from head to toe. But my eyes were still closed, And I was still dreaming or something. I could still see everything in the room as it was. And to my horror, I saw these things. I hallucinated these things in the room. Although at the time I believed it was real. But I just have to tell myself it was a hallucination. Otherwise, saying that it's real, it just doesn't really cut it, you know what I mean? Anyway, these things were running around, shimmering in and out of existence. When I finally sat up to see them, I actually did see them, but it was, I think it was a hallucination, because I was still in sort of like a weird, like, trance dream state, and I saw these shimmering out of existence, ran to the corner of the wall, and then disappeared. But the scary part is that there are two of them, and one of them went over to my mother's bed when she was completely out cold sleeping, was sniffing around on her, and then as she was, you know, as that thing was doing that, I felt this jumping on me, like a whole body shook, and my eyes met. But remember, they're closed. My eyes met with this thing in my face. It was the same reptile-looking creature, and it's the reason why I remember its eyes so well is because it was about this close to my face. I mean, that's how scary and vivid it was. And the eyes were like, you know how a cat gets really excited and they're like, ooh, my play. And the eyes dilate. Well, that's what this thing was doing. And it was like, like, I'm gonna get you, kill you, or whatever you want to do. And it had this nasty, you know, Cheshire Cat grin and these evil looking ridges going like that. And the eyes were like, you know, that. And then they had a little nose with the slits. Now, I have to say, I was not under any drug influence, people. I don't do that kind of stuff. It's stupid, and it's just a waste of your time. So that was that experience, and the next morning I woke up and I didn't say anything about it. Although I was freaking about it last day, or the night before, you know, that happened. At the time it happened, and I woke up from it. I was really scared, and I was talking to my mom, and she was just like, oh, whatever, go back to sleep, you know, like, she didn't even care. I was like, well, whatever, you know, not big deal. And I was just like, ah! And anyway, I pushed it aside until I went on the internet, and I started looking at this stuff, because I was looking at dream stuff and researching dinosaurs and dreams, because I happened to think of that, what happened, and came across David Icke and a bunch of other reptilian things, and I was like, oh, this is so weird and kind of scary, because it's kind of like the same thing that I saw, you get what I'm saying? But I still wasn't in the position to say, yeah, I think I really did see a reptilian. But I think that's what it should be called, I guess. I mean, if you see one of those types of creatures in your dreams, and it's the same kind of description. I mean, if somebody, you know, sees a monster in their dream, obviously they're gonna have, like, the same features, you know, like teeth and spikes or whatever. Okay?
Hey, yeah.